JP Nadda is now part of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's cabinet as the Union Health Minister, and he's also the chosen leader of the house in Rajya Sabha, which means the BJP is set to get its new national president. Now, there have been talks going around that BJP is set to choose a working president of the party soon. How is the party chief chosen and what is the long established procedure? Keep watching to find out. Nadda's term as the president ended in June, but there was perception that he would continue in the post till a new one was chosen at the end of the year. There is no clarity on the issue, but the party does have a one person, one post rule. Coming to the working president, once chosen by the parliamentary board, they will continue to work in the membership campaign and till the organizational election process is completed by the year end. Now, the working president can also become the national president and will begin their term in January 2025. Now, here's the interesting bit. There has never been a contest for the party's top post. And this has been the case since its formation in 1980. The BJP constitution does have provisions for it, but there's always only been one person and one candidate who's applied for this post and then been nominated to become the party president. The only time when there was a one-day flutter was in 2013 when the then party leader Yashwant Sinha took the nomination papers but did not follow up on the act. So who plays a role in who becomes the chief? When the BJP is electorally weak, like in the period after the 2009 Lok Sabha polls, the RSS plays a bigger role in choosing the party leader. This is how Nitin Gadkari was made the party chief in 2009 because the RSS wanted him to step up in leadership. Now, when the BJP is electorally strong and ruling in the centre, as it has been in the last 10 years, it's been the Prime Minister and his few confidants who play a decisive role. Lastly, what is the BJP's long-established procedure for appointing the party chief? The party begins its membership drive this month. As always, the elections to the party's local committee will be held first. Then comes polls for the mandal committees, district committees, regional committees and state committees. Once elections to half of the states have been held, the election to the national president takes place as per the BJP's constitution. Now, even though this has never happened, this is how it works. If there is more than one candidate after the date of withdrawal of nominations, then polling will be held in all states. The sealed ballot boxes will be taken to New Delhi from the state capitals and the votes will be counted. Then the candidate winning the highest number of votes will be declared the national president. The national president can then hold two consecutive terms of 3 years each. If you like this video and want more such explainers, like, share and subscribe to the Indian Express.